So a week or so ago, I started noticing that the ASC and ABS lights would illuminate simultaneously. And in a couple of cases, when that happened, or when those lights were on permanently and I restarted the vehicle, the ASC throttle body actuator and this cable essentially that pulls this closed as part of a self-test did not actually work. And one thing you'll notice is that this cable is really not secured anymore, and that's because BMW, in their infinite wisdom, created this, rather than creating a barrel here, a threaded barrel, and then putting some kind of nut on the other side of this mounting boss, they use a snap-in type receptacle or a piece of plastic that expands when you insert it. And unfortunately, with 20 years of experience, shall I say, on the car, this it just broke, and I presume it broke when we did the engine overhaul. So we never did wind up replacing the cable, and now of course this cable is loose. And what I think is happening is that occasionally, because of heat and such, the adhesive or whatever that was used to kind of help secure this or fix it has loosened up, because it's very hot now, or we're now in June, so it has loosened up. And of course the cable's like this, and of course when it's like this, it doesn't necessarily, when the actuator actually pulls this cable out, it doesn't completely sweep that throttle body. And of course the position sensor up here recognizes that and then indicates a fault. So my goal today is to actually replace that cable. So I think the first step is to get this cruise control cable out of the way. It's kind of stuck up here and integrated with this loom up here. I might have to break that table tie, but my goal then is to get this these three circular connectors, which are affixed to the fuse box by some clips here. I think I should just be able to lift that off or unclip it, and then this whole assembly will come out. And with that out, I'm not sure if you can see it, but this is the actuator right here for the ASC, and there's two nuts that fasten this to a mounting boss. It's kind of a horizontal plate, and that plate is of course mounted to this, is welded to the this body structure here. So what we need to do is pull that apart, so I can then get access to those nuts and then pull the ASC unit up through here sufficient to install the new cable. All right, I've got the ASC actuator out of the car. It's fairly straightforward. This is, of course, the Bowden cable, and you can see on the very end, this had some clips on it that, expanding clips that once you push it into the hole, it snaps into place. You can see this one part is threaded. So I'm really curious as to why they didn't just put a nut on this. It would have been a lot easier. But of course, everything is designed to be put together once and and thrown away. But anyway, the reason why I think this failed, of course, is because I'm not sure if it'll come out on camera, but this has kind of a grayish tint. This is supposed to be a black plastic component, dark black anyway. And clearly the plastic has given up the ghost with all the heat. I mean, it's very close to the engine, so it doesn't really surprise me. So I'm going to pull this cable out, and it looks like we have a little cover. Hopefully this won't break. There we go. Oh, it's convenient, little door with a seal, with a rubber seal around it. Silicone seal, possibly. So I guess the idea is you can see if I can get some better light on this. You can see how the cable attaches with that little barrel right in the top there. If I pull this cable out, not sure if it twists. It just pops out. I think it has just an O-ring seal on it. At least the new one does. Here we go. So interestingly enough, looks like I just have to meander that little barrel out of there. And if I can get the barrel out, the cable will come off. And then I just have to reinsert this. And you can see there's a little O-ring on the end of that cable piece, that end of that elbow. So by replacing the cable, you get all of this. You get this whole unit, including the new O-ring. And I should just be able to swap the cable out and put it back in. We'll see what happens. All right, so this is the new cable. It's part number 35411162495. And see, it pretty much looks like the other cable. And I only need a little bit of cable out of this end. But we'll see what happens. I think I just have to get this other cable out. Oops. See if I can. Little tight. And of course, it's a plastic gear, like a bunch of idiots. They made it plastic gear, so I don't want to damage that gear. Can't really pry up against anything to help get this out. There we go. Okay, pull the cable out. New cable in. There doesn't appear to be it looks like it's right mounted in the center, that ferrule or whatever that's crimped on there. It looks like it's right in the center. It doesn't appear to go in any particular way. But I have to get it kind of in the hole. they just had a little bit of excess clearance here, it would be great. And they like, they don't have any. Amazingly, that just, once I got it down there, it popped right in. Now the issue is, I've got to come over the lip, or that over that ridge. Figures it popped right out again. Interesting. Okay, a little finagling, but it is now in. Not going to close that quite yet. Now the trick is, I think, you have to pull the cable out this way to take up the slack so it doesn't like fall out. I don't think it really will, but all right, so that is what I should see. The ferrule is actually in there, and the wire is the stainless steel, the braided cable is actually in the little slot. So that's fine. I think that's correct. Unless I flip this around 180 degrees, I got to go back and look at my pictures. All right, I've put the new cable on the actuator, and I've just positioned or repositioned the actuator down where it needs to be. That is position sensitive. You'll see kind of how there's a rounded edge right to the edge of this connector. It's like that essentially, so it has to go in that way. You may also notice down there there's a connector just below the actuator. I initially removed that thinking I would need it for clearance, and I did not, so there's no need to remove that connector. However, these connectors as part of this assembly, these circular connectors that all connect onto this little mounting boss or whatever that attaches to the fuse block, I found it was helpful to remove those and just leave them to the side so I could pivot this whole unit kind of up and out of the way, so I could just get just enough room in here between the brake fluid reservoir and the actual throttle body and intake pipe to get the ASC unit back in. So next step is just to bolt it back up, reconnect everything, and see what happens. All right, the actuator is back in. You'll notice how the cable comes up vertically along the kind of the length of the body of the unit. And of course, that is so that the unit can just rotate down and be pushed into this mounting boss, which I will do in a moment when I have a free hand. I think the only thing to remember is just the orientation and those two hex bolts. They're 10 millimeter, and you need an extension, obviously, to get to them, particularly right between here. But I was using quarter inch drive stuff, so it worked perfectly. So next step is to plug that in, attach it to the throttle body, reconnect all the electrics, and see what happens. All right, everything is buttoned up, and I'm just doing a final adjustment of the cable. You can see this little barrel, threaded barrel. It's kind of a knurled barrel here. I adjusted this, first of all, so that the ASC throttle body is completely open. In other words, it's again back against, it's fully open against spring pressure. This is actually, if I push this, I'm pushing against the spring tension. So it's fully undone, and actually I can see that the ferrule is kind of loose in here. Actually, you might be able to see it kind of move around in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this until I take up just enough tension just kind of just barely pull this off the stop. It tightened up there. Now it started to move. You can actually, I'll just do it in an extreme case. I'll show you that it does start to move. Okay, you can see it moving that way. There it's against the stop. And right there it starts to grab. Maybe around there. So that's how I believe it should be adjusted. I didn't check in the TIS to make sure that there's any specific adjustment. I doubt there is. But that's my take anyway. So by default, the AC throttle body is completely open. And that cable, the actuator, will pull that cable and open the ASC throttle body. And actually, it does a sweep right after the engine starts, and that's what I should see next. All right, we're going to test the ASC throttle body and the new cable just by turning the key and starting the engine. All right, that appears to be it. You saw the throttle body move. That's the test. It occurs only after the engine started, so you have to actually turn the engine over for that to happen. I originally thought it was just when you turn the key on, but actually you have to start the engine. So that problem solved, and not surprisingly, there are no AC or ABS lights illuminated. So the acid test for this will be to go through multiple drive cycles and just monitor it over the next week or so. And if I don't see those lights again, it's problem solved. If this doesn't fix the problem, then I would be more likely to look at the sensor. But as that is about $100 my cost, and certainly more if you just, you know, anyone else goes into a dealer and picks it up, that was not my first choice of part to repair. This was a pretty obvious failure. And I could see why, if that ASC throttle body did not complete a full sweep as measured by that sensor, then it would flag a code, much in the same way it did when the ASC relay failed about a year ago. So hopefully that'll be the end of it.